Hello students, welcome to Understanding the Self Subject. In today's video lecture, we are going to discuss Lesson 4 of Chapter 2, and this time we will focus on the Western and Eastern perspective of the self. So when we try to compare our country to other countries, obviously, we have different cultures and we have different environment. As a result, it creates different perceptions of the self. And one of the most distinctions between cultures and people is the Eastern versus Western dichotomy. So, na-discuss na natin ito nung prelim. Narinig nyo na yung term na dichotomy. When we say dichotomy, it means two. Okay? So, the Eastern represents Asia, while the Western represents Europe and Northern America. Okay? So, ganun lang yun ka-basic. Yung sa Eastern, ito yung mga countries na kabilang sa Asia. And then sa Western naman, ito yung mga countries sa Europe and North America. But you have to remember, my dear students, that while these countries who are geographically closer to each other may share commonalities, there are also a lot of factors that create differences. So meron pa tayong ibang factors na dapat i-consider, even though merong similarities sa mga bansang ito. In the Philippines alone, each region may have similar or varying perceptions regarding the self. Okay, so let's focus first on the Western thoughts. Actually, we will not go deeper in discussing the Western thoughts. You know the reason why? Let's find out it later. Okay, so sa Western thoughts, it conducts scientific investigations. So basically, the use of scientific investigation became their basis in understanding the self. And so they developed theories and difference among them. Ganun yung way or yung approach ng mga taga-Western. What else? In the Western thought, they emphasizes the importance of scientific methods of investigation to provide satisfactory answers to understanding the self. So, gaya nga nung nasabi ko kanina, more on scientific methods of investigation ang way nila para maintindihan at ma-explain yung concept of the self. As you all know naman, in the scientific approach, diba, it's an approach seeking knowledge that involves forming and testing a hypothesis. So, kapag gumamit ka kasi ng scientific method, diba, there are certain procedures or steps to follow. And once you use scientific method kasi, you can remove the subjectivity or yung pagiging bias. Since scientific method nga siya, it requires each answer to be authenticated with objective evidence. So, ganyan ang mga Western. They want an authentic evidence to prove something about the self. What else? The Western culture is what we would call an individualistic culture since their focus is on the person. So the emphasis is individualistic rather than relational. Okay, so what do we mean by this? With the Western thoughts kasi, ang focus nila is nasa individual lang. Paano mo iintindihin yung sarili mo lang mismo. On the other hand, kapag sa Eastern thoughts naman tayo, relational siya or the relationship of an individual with other people. You are not alone. Hindi na lang ikaw yung focus. So, paano mo nabuo yung konsepto ng sarili mo in relation to other people? Okay, so basically, your relationship with others and to the society. Ganun yung pinagkaiba ng Eastern and Western thoughts. And for the last one, so this is the answer to my question a while back. Okay, so sabi ko kanina, we will not go deeper in discussing the Western thoughts. You know the reason why? Ito. It's because most of the philosophers we have discussed in our previous lessons fall under Western thoughts. Kung maalala nyo pa sila Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, John Locke, René Descartes, and many Western philosophers na na-discuss na natin nung prelim. So basically, lahat yun ay magfo-fall sa Western thoughts. Okay? Moving on to the Eastern thoughts, ano naman ang meron sa Eastern? It raises questions about the ultimate meaning of human life. They have developed theories of self as they have investigated what it means to be a human being. So sa Eastern thought kasi, they focus on the ultimate meaning of human life. Tipo bang itatanong sa'yo ng mga Eastern, bakit ka nga ba nabubuhay? What is your purpose in life? Or yung commercial ng Nescafe, para kanino ka bumabangon? So yun ang focus natin sa Eastern thought, the ultimate meaning of life. What else? Its emphasis is relational rather than individual. The self is considered not in isolation, but in relation to others, society, and the universe. So ito yung sabi ko kanina sa inyo. Kapag sa may Western, individualistic siya. Kapag sa may Eastern, it's more on relational or your relationship to other people. So dito, hindi mo na lang nilulook yung self as an individual lang or as ikaw lang, but rather, you look into relationships. Okay? So the Eastern theories are highly practical. They offer a variety of techniques for cultivating a deeper understanding of the self. And last but not the least, they do not utilize the scientific techniques of investigation. So, hindi sila gumagamit ng scientific method. Next one, we have here a closer look to different Eastern thoughts. Okay, so dito we will focus on four religions. Bakit religion, sir? Kasi in the Eastern thoughts, yung mga concept nila in understanding the self ay usually related sa religion. In this part, we will discuss four religions in Eastern Hemisphere. Okay, so we have Buddhism, Hinduism, Confucianism, and Taoism. So let's begin with Buddhism. Buddhism comes from the root word bud, meaning awake. Okay, so ano ba ang ibig sabihin ng awake? When you say awake, gising ka. Okay, ano yung ini-imply ng word na awake? It implies that when the eyes are open, it would lead to understanding more about the self and the world. So, dapat daw, para mas maintindihan mo palalo yung sarili mo, kailangan you are awake. Okay? Your eyes are open. Question, who is the founder of Buddhism? Sino bang nagpasimula ng religion na Buddhism? Okay? So, it was Siddhartha Gautama, known as Buddha, who is the founder of Buddhism. At according sa teaching ng Buddhism, take note of this, lahat daw ng tao ay may seed of enlightenment. I repeat, lahat ng tao meron daw seed of enlightenment. Anong ibig sabihin nun? Meron daw potential ang bawat isa na maging Buddha. However, the seed should be nurtured or dapat daw alagaan itong seed of enlightenment. Yan ang paniniwala ng Buddhism. So under Buddhism, they believe that man is just a title for the summation of the five parts that compose the individual. So yung man daw, pangalan lang siya na pinagsama-sama nitong limang parte na bumubuo sa isang individual. Ano yung limang parts? We have matter, sensation, perception, mental constructs, and consciousness. Eh what if hindi kumpleto itong lima? What if apat lang or tatlo lang ang meron? Therefore, it does not make a man. Yun ang paniniwala ng Buddhism. Kapag hindi sila kumpleto, it does not make a man. Okay? Additional informations sa Buddhism. They believe that there is no self or soul. Okay? So medyo familiar ba dito? As you recall, during our prelim discussion, there is also one philosopher who believes that there is no self. And who is that philosopher again? It's David Hume, okay? So, sa Buddhism, they also believe that there is nothing and all else is an illusion, okay? So, they also believe that nothing is permanent but change, okay? So, sa Buddhism, naniniwala sila that the world is ever-changing. Lahat nagbabago, okay? At alam ko familiar kayo dun sa passage na there is nothing permanent in this world except change, okay? So, paniniwala yan ng mga Buddhism. And under Buddhism, they have this term anicca. Ano yung anicca, sir? It means impermanence, okay? It means that everything in life is always changing, that nothing lasts forever. Wow, okay? So, wala daw forever. Yan ang paniniwala ng Buddhism, okay? You have to take note, my dear students, ha, na sa paniniwala ng Buddhism, you should recognize, you should acknowledge the anicca or itong tinatawag natin na impermanence, okay? Kasi daw, kapag hindi mo raw to in-acknowledge or hindi mo siya na-recognize, everything may lead to an illusion of selfhood. So kapag hindi mo kinilala yung concept ng impermanence, maaaring magkaroon ka ng illusion that there is self. Eh sabi nga natin kanina, they believe that there is no self. Okay? The ideal is to experience nirvana, a state of transcendence devoid of self-reference. So, ibig sabihin, under nirvana, wala kang concept of the self. Kasi nga, they believe in the concept that there is no self. So, according to Buddhism, nirvana is the state in which your mind is at complete peace and the soul is merged with the universe. Okay, ito ba yung tipong wala na daw gumugulo sa isipan mo, kumbaga na-achieve mo na yung tinatawag nating peace of mind. Okay, so baka naguguluhan kayo, ano yung nirvana ba? Sir, ano ba yung pwede nating i-compare sa nirvana? Actually, actually yung nirvana nila, it's parang heaven, okay? So nirvana is a place of perfect peace and happiness like heaven. So ito yung concept nila ng heaven, okay? So kailan mo lang marireach daw ang nirvana? Okay, it is rich when a person's desires and sufferings all go away and they need nor want nothing. Kumbaga, lahat ng paghihirap nila, lahat ng kagustuhan nila ay wala na. Wala na silang ibang gusto. Okay? Wala na silang possession sa mga material na bagay. And paano daw ma-achieve itong nirvana? Okay, so this state of transcendence can be achieved through meditation. Okay, so ma-achieve mo rin ito through meditation. So kung sa Western, meron tayong concept ng soul searching, sa Eastern naman, they have this meditation. So ma-achieve mo ang nirvana or yung kanilang heaven through meditation. Okay, so kung gusto ma-achieve ang nirvana, you have to go through meditation kung saan the material world is nothing. Okay, you only focus on that transcendence state. Okay, paano natin masabi na na-reach na natin ang nirvana? According to the beliefs of Buddhism, nasabi ko kanina, it is rich when a person's desires and suffering all go away and they need nor want nothing. Okay, moving on to the second religion, we have Hinduism. So, later on, kapag tinanong kayo sa exam, anong religion sa buong mundo ang may pinakamaraming followers? Anong isasagot nyo dun? The answer is Christianity. Okay, ang Islam, pangalawa lang siya. Okay, ang Hinduism, pangilan, pangatlo. Pero pag ang tanong sa exam, what is the oldest religion in the world? Ang isasagot nyo, Hinduism. Okay, so saan ba nang galing ang Hinduism? The religion of ancient people known as the Aryans. Okay, so Hinduism is the religion of the people known as the Aryans. Ang Hinduism ay galing sa bansang India. Okay, ang Buddhism saan galing? Sa India rin. Okay, so the law of karma is the most important doctrine of Hinduism. Okay, so alam ko familiar na kayo dito sa karma. Naniniwala ba kayo sa karma? That is the most important doctrine of Hinduism, the karma. Okay, so naniniwala sila that all actions will lead to a good or bad outcome in one's life. Okay, as you can see on the GIF, everything you do in your past will eventually come back to bite you. Okay, so sa Hinduism kasi, they believe that there is good karma and bad karma. So Hindus believe that Atman, being an immortal, continues to be reincarnated from lifetime to lifetime. Sir, anong ibig sabihin ng Atman dyan? Ang ibig sabihin ng Atman, it's the soul or the spirit. Okay? So naniniwala sila that the spirit or the soul is immortal. Okay? It continues to be reincarnated from lifetime to lifetime, until it is freed from the cycle of rebirth and reach a state of nirvana or non-birth. Ang mga Hindus kasi, they believe on the idea of reincarnation. At yung reincarnation na yun, hindi yun matatapos. Paulit-ulit lang daw siya. Paulit-ulit kang ma-reincarnate until you reach the state of nirvana. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng reincarnation? So when we say reincarnation, you are reborn in another body. As you can see on the image, diba, from birth until death, and then kapag daw namatay, magkakaroon ulit daw ng panibagong buhay, ngunit sa iba ng katawan or ibang physical body. Okay, pwedeng sa hayop, pwedeng sa mga plants. Okay, because they believe on the concept of reincarnation, karma does not end with the body's death. Its influence may extend through incarnation of the soul. So, ibig sabihin, yung concept of karma in Hinduism, hindi siya natatapos kapag namatay ang isang tao. It is still continuous after you reincarnated. Okay, so matatapos lang siya once you reach the nirvana or yung kanilang concept ng heaven. Klaro ba? Next one, we have Confucianism. It's a philosophy and belief system from ancient China. Actually, the Confucianism is regarded as social and ethical philosophy rather than religion. So, saan naman nag-originate ang Confucianism? It's in China. And sino ang founder? It's Confucius. Alam ko narinig nyo na yung name na Confucius. So, the core Confucian thought is the golden rule of the principle of reciprocity. So, sa Confucianism kasi, they have this principle of reciprocity. Ano yun? Do not do to others what you would not want others to do to you. So, alam ko familiar na kayo rito. Siguro nabasa nyo sa internet or nakita nyo sa mga libro. Okay? So, napakasimple ng ibig sabihin nito. Kung ayaw mong gawin sa'yo, huwag mong gawin sa iba. As simple as that. That is the principle of reciprocity. So, ito, originally galing to sa idea ng Confucianism. Okay? Kung ayaw mong gawin sa'yo, huwag mong gawin sa iba. Another important feature in Confucian thought is the individual's greatest mission of attaining self-realization, wherein self-cultivation is instrumental. So if you want self-realization daw, if gusto mong makilala yung sarili mo, it is important that you cultivate yourself first. Paano? Self-cultivation could be accomplished by knowing one's role in the society and act accordingly. As you recall, I told you a while ago that the Eastern thought is not individualistic. It focus on relation of an individual to other people and the society. And dito, makikita natin yung concept ng Confucianism. Para daw ma-achieve yung self-realization, kailangan mo muna ng self-cultivation. Ma-accomplish mo lang ang self-cultivation kapag na-recognize mo na yung role mo sa society. Okay, gets ba natin? Next one, based on the Confucian thought, moral character is perfected through continuously taking every opportunity to improve oneself in thought and action. So, hindi lang ito dapat sa isip. For example, sasabihin mo, ay, gusto ko maging mabait ngayon. Ay, gusto ko mag-improve. According sa teachings ng Confucianism, you should put your thoughts into actions. Huwag lang daw puro salita. Dapat meron ding gawa. Okay, so napapansin nyo na ba na somehow yung mga concept na dinidiscuss natin sa mga Eastern thought ay parang meron din sa Philippines or parang pinaniniwalaan rin natin mga Pinoy kasi nga part tayo ng Eastern. Ang Philippines matatagpuan sa Asia kaya dito napapasok yung commonalities, merong pagkakapare-pareho. Okay, and for the last religion, we have Taoism. It's an ancient tradition of philosophy and religious belief attributed to Lao Tzu. Okay, so saan galing ang Taoism? Sa China pa rin. So basically, yung four religions na dinidiscuss natin ay umiikot lang sa India at sa May China. Who is the founder? Lao Tzu. Okay, so Taoism believes that the self is an extension of the cosmos, not of social relationships. So naniniwala sila that the self is the extension of the cosmos. Okay? Taoism holds that humans and animals should live in balance with the Tao or the universe or yung cosmos. Okay, yung cosmos dyan, yun yung tinatawag nating universe. So kung mapapansin nyo, sa Confucianism, ang focus nila is your relationship and your status in the society. Sa Taoism naman, ang focus nila hindi social relationships but rather your relationship in the universe or yung tinatawag natin na cosmos. Yun yung difference nilang dalawa. Another one, sabi rito, they describe the self as one of the limitless forms of the Tao. Ano ba yung Tao? The Tao is commonly regarded as a nature that is the foundation of all that exists. Okay? So yan yung pinaniniwalaan ng mga tao na nagpa-practice ng Taoism. Another one, the perfect man has no self, and the selfless person leads to a balanced life in harmony with nature. There should be unity and harmony among opposing elements, the yin and yang. Okay, so alam ko familiar na kayo dito sa may gif na umiikot, that is your yin and yang. Okay, so generally speaking, okay, yung yin, it is characterized as an inward energy that is feminine, still, dark, and negative. Yung yin dyan, yan yung kulay black. Okay? On the other hand, yang is characterized as outward energy, masculine, hot, bright, and positive. Siya naman yung color white. Okay? So Taoists believe that simplicity, spontaneity, and harmony with nature should govern one's life. Therefore, there should be unity and harmony among opposing elements, the yin and yang. So the balance of yin and yang is important. If yin is stronger, yang will be weaker. And if the yang is stronger, yin will be weaker. Okay, so vice versa lang yan. Tandaan nyo, okay? Pag na-encounter nyo yung word na balance and harmony sa question sa exam, ang isasagot nyo doon, Taoism. Okay? Kasi naniniwala sila in balance and harmony. So, ang target sa Taoism is to have a balanced life of both good and bad. We should be one with nature. Hindi dapat tayo nagpo-focus sa material things around us. Okay, so moving on to the last part. And this part naman, Since we're done discussing Western and Eastern thoughts, we will try to compare the two and let us look into their differences. Okay, so first, in terms of frame of reference. So Western thoughts, there is a separation between philosophy and religion or spirituality. As you recall, nung prelim discussion natin, wala tayong na-mention na religion. Okay, so ang paniniwala ng mga Western, there is a separation between the philosophy and religion. Hindi sila pwedeng pagsamahin. On the other hand, sa may Eastern, religion and philosophy are intertwined. So ibig sabihin, magkasama sila or para magkambal, hindi sila pwedeng paghiwalayin. Okay? Sabi ko nga kanina, sa Eastern, ang basis nila in understanding the self ay usually na-associate sa religion. How about examples of school of thought? Sa may Western, papasok na dyan ang scholasticism, rationalism, empiricism, and phenomenology. Okay, so more on scientific approaches ito. Okay, gumagamit nga sila ng scientific method. On the other hand, sa Eastern, kakadiscuss lang natin, we have Buddhism, Hinduism, Confucianism, and Taoism. How about sa philosophers? Okay, so recall na lang ito sa inyo. Sa Western, na-discuss natin at nakilala natin si Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, René Descartes, John Locke, and many more. Okay, napakarami sa Western as compared sa Eastern. Sa Eastern naman, we have Confucius ng Confucianism, Lao Tzu ng Taoism, Siddhartha Gautama ng Buddhism. Sabi ko nga kanina, walang founder ng Hinduism. Okay, siguro dahil ito yung kinoconsider na oldest religion in the world. So, hindi na siguro na-recognize kung sino ba talaga ang founder ng Hinduism. And for the last slide, how about the source of knowledge? Okay, so sa may Western, they made use of reason rather than faith to pursue wisdom. So, very scientific talaga sila. At as you recall din, nung prelim natin, di ba, lagi tayong may namemention na reason, or rationalism. On the other hand, sa may Eastern, they trusted intuition and it is often associated with religious beliefs. So, basically, their basis is more on instinct, yung pakiramdam lang nila, yung feeling lang nila. And there is no need for a scientific investigation. Next, we have the modes of cognition. Sa may Western, they are analytic and deductive. So, more on analysis talaga siya. And when we say deductive, from general to specific. On the other hand, sa may Eastern, synthetic sila. At the same time, inductive. So, inductive naman from specific to general. Okay? And next one, we have the emphasis. Sa may Western, distinctions and oppositions. Okay, ibig sabihin, ang goal nila is to compare and differentiate you among others. Paano ka naiiba sa ibang tao? Pero when we talk about the Eastern thoughts kasi, ang focus nila is commonalities and harmonies. Ano yung pinagkapare-pareho ninyo? Okay? Next one, we have the view of the universe and life. Very linear sa may Western thoughts. Anong ibig sabihin ng linear? Kapag linear, di ba? Line, straight, di ba? Isang linya lang. Ibig sabihin, pinanganak ka ngayon at darating sa time na mamamatay ka. You have the beginning and you have the end. Pero sa Eastern thoughts, it's circular, pabilog. Bakit pabilog? Kasi naniniwala sila sa afterlife, na kapag namatay daw ang isang tao, mabubuhay ulit siya sa panibagong mundo. So, hindi siya nag-e-end doon. Paikot-ikot lang yung cycle. Okay? Next one, we have the view of self naman. Sa Western thought, may pagka-egocentric kasi ang focus ay yung me and I. Ako, ako, ako. Okay? Pero sa may Eastern thought, sociocentric na siya. There is tendency to put the needs, concerns, and perspective of other people or group before one's individual. Hindi na lang sarili mo yung iniisip mo. Okay? And then in terms of theological view, monotheistic ang Western thought. When we say mono, it means one or isa lang. Isa lang yung kanilang God or supreme being. Okay, sa Eastern thought naman, they are polytheistic. Okay, more than one God yung kinikilala nilang supreme being. Okay, so marami silang pinaniniwalaan na Diyos. Next one, sa ideal naman, self-actualization through personal growth. Okay, very individualistic ito. Ito ay sa may Western. And on the other hand, sa may Eastern naman, to achieve a balanced life and find one's role in society. Kung gusto mo raw mabalance yung life mo, you need to find your role in the society. And last but not the least, the cultural framework. Very individualistic talaga sa may Western. They believe that the self is distinct and autonomous entity. Independent siya from the universe and society. On the other hand, sa may Eastern naman, parte lang tayo ng society. We are just one part of the society and universe. So that explains lesson 4, the Western and Eastern concept of the self. I hope you have learned new something today. Thank you so much for joining today's session. Again, this is Sir Marvin telling you that you should never stop learning because life never stops teaching. Have a great day ahead. Thank you and goodbye.